In the previous class, we have discussed about unit step function, which is an elementary signal existing only for positive values, and its value is zero for negative time. So it is equivalent to applying a signal whose amplitude suddenly changes and remains constant forever. Here you have seen that when we are representing it mathematically, u of t is equal to 1 for t greater or equal to 0, and it is 0 for t is less than 0. So when it is graphically represented, it can be observed that its value is 0 from minus 2 to 0. When it reached 0, its value suddenly increased to 1 and remained constant forever. So this is its diagrammatic representation. This is the unit step function for discrete time signal. For discrete time signal, because in discrete time signals we use indexes n, u of n is equal to 1 for t is, for n is greater or equal to 0, it is 0 for less than 0. So when we are graphically representing it, you have seen here it is 0 from minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, it has 0 value. But when it reached at 0, for 0 and greater than 0, you have a value 1. So it is represented by a stem plot. Next elementary signal is unit ramp function. Unit ramp function also starts at 0 and increases linearly with time. So we have direct proportion. Mathematically it is defined as R of t is equal to t for t greater or equal to 0. It is 0 for t is less than 0. In other words, we are multiplying t with unit step function. So that's why we have written it here, R of t is equal to t u of t. U of t is 1, t into 1 is equal to t. For what? The values are when t is greater or equal to 0, otherwise it is 0. The ramp function has, unit ramp function has slope 1. You know that when value of value of independent variable is 1, value of the ramp function is also 1. When it is 2, value of ramp function is also 2. When it is 3, it is 3. 4, 4. So when the values have the same value on independent and dependent variables have same value, so when we divide them, we get the answer 1. So slope is basically the value which is on y-axis divided by the value on x-axis. So the value on y-axis is if 2, the value of on x-axis is also 2. So 2 by 2 is equal to 1. If it is 3 on x-axis, then it is also 3 on y-axis. 3 by 3 is 1. So unit ramp function has a slope 1. When we want to obtain it, it can be obtained by integrating the unit step function. And unit step function can be obtained by differentiating the unit ramp function. So these are the two concepts. If you want to, if you have given unit step function and you want to find out the ramp function, so mathematically how it is obtained, you integrate the unit step function, you get ramp function. So integral u of t dt, u of t is 1 for t is greater or equal to 0, 1 into dt it becomes dt, integral dt is equal to t when you are integrating discussing about the unit ramp function. It is a signal which starts at 0 and increases linearly. Its value is t for t is greater than 0 and 0 for t is less than 0. So in other words, we can say that when we multiply time with unit ramp function, we get unit step function, it becomes ramp function. Unit ramp function has slope 1, you can see that it increases linearly with the time, and the value that is on the value that is on x-axis, the same value is on y-axis, that's why the slope is 1. It can be unit ramp function can be obtained by integrating the unit step function. Here you can see that u of t, R of t is equal to integral u of t dt, which is equal to integral 1 dt, it becomes integral dt, integral dt becomes t. And if we want to obtain unit step function from ramp function, what we do, we differentiate it. It can be obtained by differentiating unit ramp function, u of t is equal to d by dt r of t, and r of t is what? R of t is t for t greater than 0, so that's why we put it here d by dt into t, so it becomes 1. Graphically it is represented as, you have seen that here we have when it is 0 it is 0, when it will become 1 it will be 1, when it is 2 it's 2, it is 4, it becomes the value 4, when it is 6, value becomes 6, so slope is 1. Next is unit ramp function, discrete time unit ramp function. Discrete time unit ramp function is defined as R of n is equal to n for n is greater or equal to 0, 0 for n is less than 0. It is graphically represented as n is here and this is r of n, and we are graphically representing it when it is 0, 0, it is 1, 1, 2, here we have 2, 3, we have 3, 4, we have 4, we have 5, and this is 5. So this is the diagrammatic representation of discrete time unit ramp function. Third one we are discussing now, it is unit parabolic function. A continuous time unit parabolic function, P of t, is defined as P of t is equal to t square by 2 for t is greater than 0. Greater or equal to 0, and it is 0 for t is less than 0. In other words, you can write it, p of t is t square divided by 2 u of t, because u of t is 1, t square by 2 into 1, it becomes t square by 2. The unit parabolic function can be obtained by integrating the unit ramp function or double integrating the unit step function. Here we have seen that p of t, you have taken the double integral of u of t, which is dt. When we are taking integral of u of t dt, it becomes integral of u of t is 1, basically u of t is 1. When we are taking integral 1 into dt, it becomes t. So that's why we have removed this part and we get t. When we are applying integral on u of t, it becomes t. Next we apply the second integral on t dt, so it becomes t square by 2. So this is for t is greater or equal to 0. So you have given unit step function, you can obtain parabolic function. But if you have given parabolic function and you want to obtain ramp function, how you will do this? You will differentiate it. You will take its derivative. Here we have taken d by dt p of t, d by dt. Now p of t is what? T square divided by 2. When we are taking its derivative, 2 is constant, derivative of t square is what? 2t. 2t divided by 2. This 2 is cancelled, you get just t. U of t is equal to d square dt square p of t. Here you have used d square dt square t square divided by 2. It is d by dt. Here when we are taking first derivative, we get t. Then d by dt of t, it becomes 1. So here the concept is that you have given unit step function, you will take its double derivative, you will get the parabolic function. If you have given unit ramp function, you will take its derivative, its integral. You have given unit step function, you will take its double integral, you will get parabolic function. And if you have given ramp function, you will take its integral, then you will get parabolic. In the second part you can see, if you have given parabolic function, you want to find ramp from it, you will differentiate it. So that's why r of t is equal to d by dt of p of t. And if you have given parabolic function and you want to find unit step function from it, you will take its double derivative, d square dt square p of t, and then you will get the 1. So when we are plotting p of t against t, then we have this type of graph here. This is the graph of parabolic signal. This is the case when we are dealing with unit step parabolic function for discrete time. A discrete time unit parabolic function is defined as p of n is equal to n square divided by 2. For n is greater or equal to 0, it is 0. For n is less than 0. So in other words, p of n is equal to n square divided by 2 u of n. And it is, you can say, when you will plot it, it will increase in this way. When it is 0, it is 0. When it is 1, you will get the 1. When it is 2, it becomes 2. When it is 1, it is 0.5. It is 2. 2 square becomes 4. And 4 divided by 2, it becomes 2. When it is 3, it becomes 4.5. When it is 4, it becomes 4 square is 16. 16 divided by 2, it becomes 8. And similarly, these points will be plotted here. So in this lecture we basically discuss three signals. one was the unit step. We have explained it in its in discrete time and continuous time. Similarly, we have discussed the continuous time unit ramp and discrete time unit ramp functions. And lastly, we have discussed the continuous time and discrete time parabolic functions. Now I will explain the concept of all this in MATLAB. Thank you. First, I will explain generating. This is a lab that you will conduct. Generating elementary continuous time and discrete time signals using MATLAB. Here we will generate unit step, unit ramp, and parabolic signals, which we have just discussed in the lecture. The objective of this experiment is to generate continuous and discrete time, unit step, unit ramp, and parabolic signals in MATLAB. You should have a computer with MATLAB software. So first we will discuss a continuous time unit step function u of t, how we can implement it in MATLAB. It is mathematically represented as u of t is equal to 1 for t is greater or equal to 0. It is 0 for t is less than 0. Here we can see we have written this program in MATLAB, and there are some commands which we have written. Here first is clear all. Basically, when we are dealing working with the command prompt or command window, we write some variables there. This clear all removes all the variables from the workspace. They are stored in the workspace, such as in the MATLAB. You can see here, if we have a is equal to 2, so you see here this variable has come here in the workspace. B is equal to a plus 3. So no another variable b whose value is 5 is here. We want that we should remove all these variables from the workspace. Then what we will do? We will do clear all. So now you see that there is nothing here in the workspace. If you want that, if you have seen here, there is some mess on the screen. A is equal to 2, B is equal to A plus 3, the commands that we have written, they are on the screen. If you want to delete them, remove from the screen, then you will use the CLC command. It will clear the screen for you. So similarly, there is one more command that we have there. Suppose I am just creating a figure and I am writing here close all. Initially you see here you have this figure, but when I will execute this, you will see that there is no figure. It has closed. If you had so many figures or files are open, then it will close all. It will close all of them. So close all means either it will close all the figures that are open here. So that's why in the start of the code we have written this. It is not mandatory to write these things in the code. You can write your code without them. So first thing that in this code is we want to display our output on some screen. For this we created a figure. Normally if you will just execute this command figure, you see one template is here and this template has light gray color. Here the color is light gray. But if we will write this command, the name of the figure will be the figure 1, and one more thing that will be there is that its background is white now. So if all the parameters here, they are 1 1 1, so you will get white background. So in previous case, if by default it comes light gray background, if you want the background of your own choice, you can make changes here. Here I have used the value 1 1 1. When we will write here 1 1 1, it will be 1. When we will write 0 0 0, it will be black. And the values which will be if we hit 1 0 0, it will be blue. So you can have the background of your own choice. You can change the values whatever you want. Next, we have used this inline function. This inline function, basically what does it do? Here we have written here t is, suppose we are doing the things for t is greater than 0, then it will take only show the results for only those values which are greater than 0. For others it will give 0. So here we will do the things. You have given the data. T is starting, T1 is minus 2, T2 is 4, so its range is T1 to T2. So it means which the values that we have given, they are in between minus 2 to 6. It's minus 2, it's 6. So values are in between 2 to 6. So you can check here T. You have T2 values, minus 2 and 6. What fplot does, it uses this information and plots x, and x is obtained on the basis of this criteria, t is greater than 0, and depending on the value of t. So when t is less than 0, it will put there 0. It will also consider t is greater than 0, it means it will be 1 when it is greater than 0. So you can see here minus 2 to 0. Here you have seen that it is, and it is giving you the result. It is unit ramp function. So this is the blue line. It is 0, then so you can also put some labels there, x label and y label. This is the x label, with its font size, Y label and title of the figure, other things. These are also for some formatting issues. So now the figure will appear like this. Here on x-axis you have the label t, on y-axis you have the label u of t. And its title is continuous time unit step signal. So you have initial figure, these things were not there. So on x label you have given t, you have put its font size 12, its font weight is bold. It can be normal, you can put here italic or other thing, what you want. Y label is u of t, as it is u of t is written here, font size is 12, font weight is bold. Title, continuous time unit step signal, its font size is also 12 and font weight is bold, that appears here. You can also write the script for this code. And you can paste it. Now you will save it some of your directory. Create a folder MATLAB codes. And give it title unit step. So when you will execute it, you will get your output. Okay? So this is, you have written a script in the on command window. You can just write the commands and one by one you can trace them. Here you can write the whole code and then execute it. Okay? We have done this in both ways. Similarly, you can also go for the code that is for we have already written for discrete unit step function. And you can go for the new and put it here, save it, and unit step discrete DIS and save it. So similarly you will get your result. Here what we have done, we have taken the n is minus 529, minus 529, and we have generated the figure. Next we write here zeros of 1, 5. The first 5 indexes will have 0 value, minus 5, minus 0, minus minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, they will have value 0. So that's why we have written here zeros of 1, 5, and next 0 to 9, these are the 10 numbers. 0 to 9 we will have ones of 1, 10. So when you are doing this, you can see here in the command window, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 ones. So next what you did, you plotted. Which plot function you have used? You have used stem plot. Previously you were using fplot. When you are using some inline functions or something, then you will use fplot. Otherwise we use plot function normally. In case of for plotting discrete time signals, we use stem plot. Other things are same, x label, y label, the things that you put, they are same. What is difference here? Instead of fplot or plot, you use here stem plot, STEM, and pass the variables and plot it. So this was the discrete time unit step function. Next we will go for the ramp. Similarly you will copy all this code here. You what you have written here, inline t, here you don't write t is greater than 0 or less than 0 or something else, just what you write here, t. What you have written here, t. So the value that you will give, that will appear in a specific range. So next you did t is the similar way, then plot it, and other are the just x label, y labels. And so when you are create a new file script, save it, ramp underscore continuous. Now run it. this was the unit ramp function. Similarly, you can do the same for continuous time case. Just put it here, and just I'm plotting these. Just don't change the things, just put it here and execute. So this was the case for unit ramp sequence, which is a digital signal. What is difference? In this case you are using the stem plot, and in case of continuous, you are generating the signal using inline function, and then using the f plot. Similarly, next we will go for continuous time parabolic in MATLAB. Just paste it. And execute it. This is the plot of continuous time unit ramp function. Parabolic function. Continuous time parabolic function. Similarly, you can plot continuous time, discrete time parabolic function. Is this is the code for it. So in this class you discuss these three continuous time and discrete time signals, unit step, unit ramp and parabolic, and implemented them in MATLAB. Any question related to